Why do science, why people do science, why people study the knowledge? There are two aspects in this. One is that individual aspect, individual. If you go to a scientist or researcher and if you ask him, so why are you doing this research? So in the individual perspective, the person, the researcher who is studying a particular topic, he may be interested, he may find some joy in finding the fact which is not known to the world. So he wanted to tell the world a fact about the nature which is not known. Or if it was given in a wrong way previously, he wanted to disprove that theory by his experimentation and observation. So what do he gain by that? He gained some personal satisfaction and joy by doing the work. And he gets the joy by finding the facts of nature which were not revealed by the humans so far on this planet. So he is going to be the first person who revealed the fact about a particular fact about the nature. So personal joy, individual perspective. Personal joy. And with that joy, at the same time, they will get the reputation also. They will be awarded for their work, which is very difficult, for which they have to spend a lot of time, years of their lifetime, and spend a lot of money in doing the work. And they have to overcome so many hardships and challenges to reveal such facts. So individual perspective. Okay, the second one is societal perspective. So here we have seen the individual perspective of researchers or scientists in studying science. They have personal joy. Societal perspective, keeping the society in idea, finding solutions to different challenges for the mankind. So we see the society, the humans, they require so many solutions for different problems by which many people are suffered. So keeping this in view, different researchers, the researchers that they belong to the environment, they study the environment, they study the earth, they study the environmental climatic patterns, they study the weather, they study the changes in the weather. So this is to predict the cyclones or rains or weather patterns, change in the weather patterns. So this information, this knowledge is helpful in protecting the crops, protecting the plants. So taking the preventive measures to prevent the loss of human life in case of a cyclone or such conditions. So keeping the welfare of a society in mind, some research work goes on. Even we see that population is growing up. So food demand, to meet the food demand. As the population is growing up, demand for the food is also grows up. Food has to be, it is a very important necessity of mankind. To increase the production of the food, researchers are carrying out research. They are finding out high yielding varieties of plants and animals which will give a good product. They are finding good varieties which can resist the adverse climatic conditions, which can resist the floods, which can resist the heavy winds likewise. So, development of good variety of plants for high production of food, that is to meet the demands of growing population. So keeping the societal welfare, medicines and technology. So many medicines, pharmaceuticals are discovered to cure diseases. So there are so many diseases threatening the people around the world. Diseases like HIV. So they are very dangerous and dreadful, and cancers. So the scientists are always finding a way, cure to these diseases, and they are finding the medicines which can cure the disease. Even we see that they are trying to find the preventive measures like vaccines for many of the diseases. Vaccines were discovered and these vaccines are helping to control many diseases. So keeping the society in mind, the research work goes on. So that is the societal perspective. Even to meet the energy demands for transportation or generating electricity, sources like petroleum, natural gas, identification of petroleum and natural gas in the ground, exploration of these natural resources and utilization. So natural resources are very important for the economic growth of a country. So keeping the economic growth of a country in mind, the scientists or researchers work in finding out the natural resources, utilizing the natural resources to increase the wealth of a country. So by that, so economic growth is achieved. So this is all the study, this is all the science that related to the welfare of a society, of a particular country. So the science that is studied by people, so we can see here two different aspects, individual perspective and societal perspective. So whatever may be, the study of that knowledge by experimentation needs a lot of reserves, funds also. So the government, it promotes the research work because the research is always in the benefit of mankind. So the government, it promotes, even the non-government organizations also promote the research work and encourage the scientists to carry out their research. So at the present situation, even scientists are working on the solutions that are created by the technology and scientific technology already which is existing. We see that when the plastic was discovered and introduced, we felt like it was a wonderful material. So it can resist any number of microorganisms and it can stay durable for a very long time. But now we are thinking that it is a very dangerous one in the environment, which is not degrading. So the quality we appraised at that time, the plastic is not decomposed, so we can use it for a very long time. Now we are cursing the same quality. The scientists are finding a way to dispose this kind of waste. So it is born out of science. A lot of research has been done to make the product, make that material plastic. Now we are finding a way to end that material. So now we are looking for some alternative. So for the environmental problems also the scientists are looking for. So the main aim of this science is for a better future. It may be the better economic future, better environmental conditions. So the future should be good. That is the reason why the science is studied. It is appreciated by every person because out of the curiosity, and there is a hope that science will make the life, the human living, it will improve the human living standard. So that hope and trust on the science will make everybody appreciate the study of the knowledge, that is the science.